Chris, the beauty of sports is that they bring all of us together, no matter what walk of life we come from.
That's true, Tom. Hall of Fame football coach Tom Landry once said, football is an incredible game. Sometimes it's so incredible, it's unbelievable. And with that, as calls for change come from every corner of the country, I talk with area coaches to see how this incredible game works to bring everyone together.
Football is a sport that's all about teamwork, love, and camaraderie, an atmosphere that many coaches think our everyday world could learn from. Some of the top high school coaches in the state set out to create an environment that reflects those beliefs.
We got a great locker room. We don't just have black kids, we got white kids, but we don't hear, you know, friction and all that stuff because we treat everybody like, you know, that's my brother. We don't treat him like that's my black brother, that's my white brother, like that's my brother.
Starkville head coach Chris Jones and Tupelo head coach Ty Harden are both leaders of some of the biggest locker rooms in the state. Both believe it's important to practice what you preach.
The whole saying, actions speak louder than words, and I think that's what culture is. It's just what you do every day and what people see. And that's one thing about 13 to 18-year-old young men, they can see through anything. They're some of the smartest people on earth. They can see if somebody's real and somebody's
fake, and their words or however y'all say it, man, they're going to let you know. And to me, you always want to just try to come correct with kids, but because if you don't become correct with kids, they'll correct you.
Athletes across the country are using their voice when it comes to societal issues, including high school athletes. Coaches know that and are taking out the time to listen and have conversations to better understand their athletes' thoughts and feelings.
The first day we were together as a team, that June 1st date, that was the first thing I wanted to address because it's something that you need to and have to.
Most of it is just listening, to be honest with you, just kind of get their opinion on it because I don't want to jump to conclusion and tell them this is how you should feel. I can't tell you how you should feel. I want to know how you're feeling first, and maybe let me think about it and let me kind of figure out how I can reach you and help you understand what's going on and help feel and understand your pain.
Wins and championships are always the goal when a team steps foot on the gridiron, but that's not the end-all be-all. The same messages coaches are telling their players to get the win on Friday night are the same messages they believe the young men they're molding will carry with them the rest of their lives.
You can't deny that you're black, you're white, but what you also can't deny is a person's heart. It's bigger than just like your world, your culture. See, to me that helps you understand, like, you know, this kid who didn't grow up the way you grew up, who might not have a meal tomorrow, but you sympathize for that kid because I'm in the locker room, that kid, I know kids go hungry, you know, because my best friend used to be that way or whatever the case may be because I played ball with him, versus your circle, all y'all rich, all y'all got money, y'all don't understand what it feels like to not have, mm-hmm. Like, versus, yeah, I'm rich or whatever the case may be, but I play with some guys who don't have. You know, and it hurts me to see that they don't have. Hopefully, you know, when the guys leave me, you know, when you're 19, 20, you're 30 years old, you know, you can have that same effect on your wife, your kids. And guess what they're going to do? They're going to have that effect on another family and another family and another family.
In order to reach the athletes they see every day, both coaches know there's one important key to send their message.
We have to adapt because y'all are the future and y'all got some bright ideas. And sometimes we're so set in our old ways, and we don't get a chance to like truly open up and see, like, okay, you might have a point.
If you're not able to adapt and get what the times are going on, you'll get left, or you're not going to reach these people that are out here. You're not going to be able to connect with them because you've got to adapt to them, and you've got to do what's right by them.
Once the stadium lights turn off, the bleachers are empty, and the game is over, Harden holds firm to this belief about the world.
And this generation of young adults are going to be the people to change it.
In Columbus, Chris Bolton, WCBI Sports.